Rise and Shine on Australia's Vision Christian Radio.
Brand new week, brand new podcast. Fel and DJ here with you for your Monday. Thank you so much for tuning in. Fel, how are you doing over that side of the desk?
Yes, all good.
Now, again, behind the scenes, and we've talked about this a little bit a long time ago. We'll talk about it again now. Fel is now the captain of the ship. She's sitting over here.
I suppose. Pressing
the buttons.
Yes.
Sliding the sliders, keeping an eye on all the bells and whistles, and I'm over here trying to work out what I'm doing on this side of the desk.
That is right. Yeah, we've given you some tasks over there, but yes, it's a bit of a challenge. You have to keep you busy.
And it's again, I don't want anybody to think like I've been demoted
different. Just different roles.
It's a totally different thing, and I'm so used to being the button pusher.
Yeah.
But now I'm sort of sitting over here going, hang on, I've only got this one screen and a screen over here. So it's a lot of fun behind the scenes trying to work out what I'm doing. I want to get onto the socials a bit more and get a lot of people activated in the Facebook group.
Great idea.
The Facebook page.
Awesome.
Having a lot of chats around that. We might even do some more live things over there.
Mm.
So if you haven't got onto our Facebook page or our Facebook group, make sure you do that because we might be doing some more stuff from the studio in there. But going forward, on the show today, we kick off Marriage Week.
That's right. So we do have Brett and Kate. We've asked them, they're going to come back every day this week, which is very fun. We did give away some passes to ChosenCon.
Yes.
So that's been a big focus. We also gave away some Lauren Daigle tickets. So we've been very giving today.
Yeah, we're very generous. Very generous. Just call us, the generous people out
indeed,
here.
Indeed.
But strap yourselves in. It's a lot of fun, this show. Make sure you're listening throughout the entire week for Marriage Week. There's an amazing prize. You'll hear us talk more about it with Brett and Kate throughout the week. If you go to vision.org.au/giveaways, an amazing prize to go to Brett and Kate's incredible marriage retreat happening in just a couple of months. So stick around. You'll hear all about that on today's podcast.
The Rise and Shine podcast.
Thank God I do.
Lauren Daigle, thank God I do. And we're thanking God because Lauren is on her way to our shores.
That reminds me, we are still got a few of the winners to give tickets away because we, while I was away, ran a competition for Lauren Daigle tickets.
That's right.
She's coming to the country in November.
Yes.
And let's see if we can't get a very, very special winner here in Sydney. On the phone right now, have we got the legendary, world-famous Wilma?
It is.
But Wilma, I'm so excited that we can give you a call because your name is Wilma and your last name begins with a letter F.
Yes.
How many Flintstone jokes have you suffered in your life? There must have been so many.
Too many.
Well, hopefully Fred and Dino, Pebbles and all the gang are great there where you are there in Sydney. But do you remember entering a competition to win some tickets to see a little lady by the name of Lauren Daigle?
Yes, and I got an email to say that I had won the
team. The email team beat us. Well, we were hoping to surprise you that you didn't check your email just yet. But, Wilma, you're too across it there. Hey, congratulations. You're heading off to the Sydney event in November. Whereabouts are you going to be driving in from?
Riverwood.
Okay, beautiful, beautiful.
Yeah.
Not too far away at all.
But I will be selling and going on up to Brisbane.
Oh.
So, yeah, I'll have to I've got someone interested at the moment in purchasing the house. It's not on the market yet.
Oh, wow.
I'll have to tie you in sort of around that date.
Yeah, well, okay. You will have to make sure you see Lauren and then head up north.
Yeah, sail the day and then go see Lauren and then moving right up here.
It'll be a good celebration.
That's right.
Oh,
hey, Wilma, congratulations. We're so stoked for you to go see it and hopefully it's a great night and hopefully I'm praying that that everything sells up well there in Sydney.
Thank you.
Thanks, Wilma.
Yeah.
Have a great day.
Bless you.
You too.
Bye.
Bye.
Thanks. Bye.
Oh, that's wonderful. I love giving away prizes. And, well, we've got quite a few prizes to give away today.
Yeah, we do. We do. Now, Lauren Daigle, coming to the country in November. Do you have those dates handy, Fel?
Yeah, that's right. So she's on the 14th of November. She will be in Sydney.
Okay.
And then the 12th, she's actually in Melbourne, 17th in Perth, and the 9th in Brisbane. So that's actually in the wrong order. But if you're in those areas, look her up. It's the Kaleidoscope Tour.
Fantastic.
Which looks so colourful. And I've been following her along on that tour in the US, and it looks incredible. So amazing. If you can get along to that, there's still tickets available. So jump online And you could be going and seeing Lauren. You don't have to wait for a
You don't have to wait for our ticket, but if you're in Sydney, just look for Wilma and her husband Fred, and maybe the you know the car, the footless car that's outside with Dino waiting out there. Could be. No, sorry, I couldn't leave without another Flintstone joke.
Great conversations, fun, inspiration, and more. Rise and shine with Felon DJ on Vision.
Now, all through the show, we're giving away tickets to the Chosen Con. If you're a fan of the television show The Chosen. I know there's plenty of you out there. You've got your DVDs, your Blu-rays, your Chosen shirts. Well, there's a Chosen Con that's happening in a couple of weeks, less than a couple of weeks now, in the States. If you can't get over there, and believe it or not, I do know there's a few Australians flying over there.
Incredible.
For the conference. I know, they're hardcore fans. if you want to get some virtual tickets to be able to watch it all online in the comfort of your own home, give us a call and let us know your favorite chosen quote, your favorite chosen line. If there's a particular line that has really hit you and stuck with you, let us know. We might be able to give you a ticket for Chosen Con, 1-800-316-316. But right now, we've got the Vision National News. Tracy and the team here on Rise and Shine.
It's the best way to start your day. Rise and Shine with Fel and DJ on Vision.
All the songs and the artists in the correct order and win a great prize. It's Rise and Shine's Music Machine.
By my calculations, I think we're up to $100 today.
Okay, so not a record yet, but not a record. On the way.
We're creeping up there. What are we doing? Music Machine. This is where we have five songs for you to guess from five different decades, 70s, 80s, 90s, aughts, and the 10s. We only have one more song to guess, all right? And because of the theme, Dion, the legendary Dion, guessed the theme. It's a very, I think it was a very, you know.
Underwhelming?
Complicated, oh, right. Very smart, clever theme.
Oh, okay.
Was alphabetical, A, B, C, D, E. That's what we know. Each song begins with another letter of the alphabet. So if we go through it, we have got the 70s, a love song. From the 80s, we've got By Your Spirit. The 90s is the one that we've stumped everybody, but we know that it starts with the letter C, D, Casting Crowns, Does Anybody Hear Me? And then at the end there, we've got the afters with Every Good Thing That Starts With an E. Let's have a listen to the mixtape. We've got a longer bit for the 90s. Everybody else has just got a shorter bit of the song. But let's see what you can hear here. We kick off in the 70s. We've got that one sorted. That's a love song. Now we've got By Your Spirit, Leslie Phillips. This is the one we're trying to guess. We stumped everybody with that one. Casting Crowns from the Aughts, Does Anybody Hear Her? And we finish it off with the afters. Every Good Thing. Now, I've given you a hint for the 90s one.
Mm.
I said Blue-Eyed Soul.
Oh, that's right.
All right, Blue-Eyed Soul.
Sorry, say that again.
Blue-Eyed Soul. All right, there's a...
That doesn't really even mean anything.
Well, it does to people know that genre
we'll
of music.
If you think that is an actual clue and not just words strung together, you can give us a call and let us know what you think. 1-800-316-316. I wonder if there is anyone who knows that song.
I think there will be. There's going to be somebody.
Rise and Shine. It's Rise and Shine's Music Machine.
All right, now I think I've stumped everybody. Australia is stumped with the 90s song here. Why don't we have a listen to the Music Machine right off the bat here, and then I'm going to give you another clue for the song from the 90s. So we'll pop the tape in. We start off in the 70s with a love song. My love song. And then Leslie Phillips, By My Spirit. This is the one we're trying to guess. '90s song beginning with the letter C. We know this is Casting Crowns. And then we finish off with the afters, Every Good Thing. Everyone's done such a great job, got it, pulling it all together. We know that the 90s songs begin with the letter C. It's by a particular artist. It's by a one-man artist. It's not by a band. It's a one person. I've given you the hint, Blue-Eyed Soul. I'm going to give you another hint right now. This is one of the few, if not the only, Christian artist who can say that he has performed with and for both Stevie Wonder and Michael Jackson.
Okay.
All right.
Doesn't help me, but it might help you. If it does, you can give us a call.
I'll have some more clues on the way here. But I might even give you some more of the song there. If you go back to the early 90s, Wonderful song. If you like, you know, if you like that sort of sound, you know where we're coming from. It's probably the person you're thinking of. You've just got to find the song that begins with the letter C to finish off, you know, our mixtape this morning, our music machine this morning there. So let us know. It jacks up to $110 tomorrow. Thanks to the Armory Bookshop. You go over to the Armory Bookshop online and find all the resources you need for, you know, not only just great Bibles, but all the study material, reading material you might want. You can get that voucher and spend it for, you know, with them right there. All we need is that 90 song and then all the songs put into order.
There you go.
Easy.
And then it's done.
It's the daily podcast of your favourite Aussie breakfast show, Rise and Shine. Rise and Shine.
You're on Vision with Fel and DJ.
Well, it's Monday, and so it's unusual, but this is a very special week. It's Marriage Week. It kicked off yesterday. So who better to chat with on Marriage Week than, well, I think of marriage themselves, Brett and Kate Ryan. How are you doing, guys?
I'm just sort of getting over that. It's unusual. I feel like, you know, it's unusual to me.
Oh, wow. He's singing. He's singing for Marriage Week.
Keep going. We'll just do 3 minutes of Brett singing.
No. Actually, can you edit that?
No. It's definitely staying in.
This is live. Now, listen, Marriage Week, what is it all about? What is Focus on the Family and Vision doing around Marriage Week?
Well, it's actually not our event. There's actually another ministry called Marriage Week, and we're partnering along with them. But anytime anyone's talking about marriage,
we're in.
I love it.
And we love what they're doing, and we want to do as much as we can. And we've actually got a new resource just for this that launched this week called Helping Couples Thrive, and it's got a variety of different things. It's a downloadable ebook. It's about 16 pages worth of content, and we're doing a number of radio interviews talking about it, and then also we're loving the idea of partnering with Vision Christian Media to bring you a special prize called Journey to Us. And it's a marriage retreat weekend where we actually do an intensive 2.5 days or almost 3 days worth of content to help invest in people's relationships.
Wow, I love it. And look, we did speak a bit about it on Friday, and it just sounds terrific. Mm. If people are like, well, I'll put my name in for the prize, but can they buy tickets to come along anyway? What's involved if someone says, hey, I'd love to come and I don't have to just win? There is another way to get there. How do they buy tickets? How do they get along?
They can go to our website at families.org.au. In the bottom of the website landing page, you'll see events, Journey to Us, and it's got all the details there about this weekend. And people say, well, it seems like a lot of money. A lot of people who have come saying it's too cheap. It's worth far more. So, again, people have to take in consideration this. It is valued at $950, but most of that goes towards food and accommodation.
Yes. And that's $950
for a couple.
That's $950 for a couple.
Yes, I know. It's interesting because if you go away for a weekend and you stay in a hotel and you buy meals at a cafe or restaurants for the whole weekend, you'd be paying a whole lot more.
Yeah.
And I guess it comes down to, what are people's priorities?
Mm.
And so often we think we just coast along in our marriage and we go, oh, that'll work itself out. Often it doesn't just work itself out. It ends up magnifying any issue that might be there. And let's face it, the longer you push something under the rug, the bigger it gets, you know, when you lift that rug up. Mm. Often it happens when your children leave the nest, I'm just going to say. Because you're in a very busy season when your children are young. And then when you kind of, they start to leave, you go, you look at your spouse and you go,
Who are you?
Who are you again? What are we doing here?
Yeah, what are you doing here? And we've got a few issues that we hadn't kind of worked through along the way.
Mm.
And so just setting time aside is so precious.
Yeah.
Not distracted,
yes.
Intentional time to each other. We create a lot of opportunities for having healthy conversations. And Kate and I and a team of other people will present lots of different content over the weekend. But there'll be plenty of opportunities, including providing you for a free counselling service if you would like. You don't have to have it, but it is also available to you.
And that's a funny thing too, because a lot of people go, oh, counsellors, only people who are failing or really struggling will see a counsellor. And we debunked that myth in the first, you know, evening. You'd be surprised. Nearly everybody signs up.
Yeah.
And they say it's one of the best things that they've done.
Okay, okay.
Think about us. I love the counselling.
Yeah, exactly. Well, okay, well, we've got to get involved here. vision.org.au/giveaways, all right? vision.org.au/giveaways. If you want your chance to win a $950 ticket to Journey to Us, it includes everything except the plane flight. If you live in a state, it's all happening just outside of Melbourne. So if you're in Victoria, you're laughing. But if you want to get involved and get there, you can win it on Vision and focus on the family here. Guys, we're going to try to chat to you every day this week during marriage week. So hopefully you've got some time up your sleeve, because we'd love to hear more about it and get as many people as we can along to the Journey to Us conference, little weekend retreat there happening all in a couple of months there. That'd be fantastic.
And we've had people from all over Australia, as far as Cairns and Western Australia, Tasmania, all over. And so it's not just Victorians. And everyone that has come along has always found it of great benefit. Things that we can have and see true transformation in relationships, building a marriage that you'll both love.
Oh, so good. Well, we'll have you back, Brett and Kate, tomorrow as we work our way through Marriage Week.
Yeah.
And if that's of interest to you, if you want to get involved and try and get one of those passes, you jump onto vision.org.au giveaways.
Easy.
And you can find out all about the retreat there as well. And if you're a Chosen fan,
yep,
have we got the prize for you? There we go. Trying to sell it here. ChosenCon is coming up not long away. In fact, the website tells me it's 11 days, 1 hour and 21 minutes
Counting? Who's counting? Yeah. It's the ChosenCon is going to be absolutely huge. I think it's the second one that they've done. They do that in person and they do it over in Florida. Now, you know, if you can't afford a ticket to Florida, listen, we've got you covered. You can go to the ChosenCon virtually. We've got 4 tickets to give away. You can watch it online. And all we're asking you to do is give us your best quote from The Chosen. And I'm going to steal one. I'm going to give people an example here.
Yes, Bill, well, then you could just use DJs and quotes.
Well, no. We want you to come up. I'm going to use the most popular one. This is one of the most popular ones from the season one, from the earliest season. And this is one of the ones that went viral very, 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 very early on in the life of The Chosen. Mary Magdalene was asked about why she was different, what had changed her. And she was trying to give her testimony. In the end, she just simply says, listen, I was one way and now I'm completely different. And the thing that happened in between was him. Great classic quote. It went viral when that episode came out. So that's what we got. You might have something. Might be from Mary Magdalene. Might be from any of the disciples there, or even Jesus himself from The Chosen Show. Is there a particular line or a quote from The Chosen that has just stuck with you and hit you right between the eyes? Let us know. We would love to give you a pass to The Chosen.
And we're bringing back a segment, Spin It or Pin It.
Yes, and we've got a jingle. I was waiting for the Lockie jingle to launch into it.
Oh, well, here you go. This is thanks to Lockie, one of our wonderful listeners in WA, who put this together for it.
Spin it or pin it. 2 new songs, but you can only vote for one. Vote for your favourite on Vision's Instagram or Facebook.
There you go. Oh. Well said, Lockie.
Makes it so simple.
The idea is there are 2 songs, sort of like a boxing match, and we get to choose which one we like the best over the course of the week.
Yes.
There's a post on Facebook where you can post your ideas, or you can give us a call at any time.
Exactly. You can even let us know what you want. Now, we've turned it over to you, Spin It or Pin It, we've turned it over to you to nominate the new songs that you want to hear. And I put the call out there amongst all the music lovers, the Vision family, and we had a fantastic message for the first song we're going to be playing you, just part of it, from Ruth in Tasmania. Ruth, what have you got to say?
Hi, this is Ruth from Tassie. For the return of Spin It or Pin It, I would love to nominate a great new song by Gable Price and friends called Newspaper Boat. I really love this song, especially the lyrics that say, it seems like everybody's dying, but is there anyone just dying to live? Seems like everybody's crying, but nobody's really trying to forgive. I think everyone will love this. Thanks.
Oh,
thank you, Ruth.
Love this nomination, Ruth. Ruth is always up with the new music. So let's have a listen to the first minute or so of Gable Price and Friends, a brand new band from California, from Bethel in California, and touring massively around the States at the moment. They've got a few EPs and albums under their belt already. But this is the first single off their new EP. It's called Newspaper Boat. Here for your Spin It or Pin It. So there you have it. There's a taste of Gable Price and Friends, one of my new favourite upcoming bands that's making their waves in America. They're nominated by Ruth. That's our first entry in the return of Spin It or Pin It, something to get you up and going in the morning, a bit of rock for you. Now, up against that, we put the call out there. We asked you for your nominations, and Marky Van answered the call. This is what Marky Van has nominated.
Hey, guys. It's Marky Van from Highton. Looking forward to this awesome return of Spin It or Pin It. And this is going to be an awesome song this week. Can't wait. I have asked for a brand new rock song by Skillet. It's called Unpopular. It's got an awesome video as well. This song is great. It has a massive, big rock sound, and the lyrics really capture the feelings of today's crazy world. I know it's called Unpopular, but I think you'll love it. It's going to be very popular, so have a great day, guys. God bless.
I was waiting for the unpopular popular joke there.
You have to do that.
Now, we know Skillet. Skillet's been around for ages, decades and decades. You know, classic, you know, at this age, a big classic Christian rock band. And they've got a brand new single ahead of a brand new album. It's called Unpopular. Now, you're going to have to strap your rock and roll boots on for this one. This one is big. This is Skillet, nominated by Marky Van. Is this the song you're going to choose for Spin It or Pin It? It's called Unpopular. Turn it up.
Am I the only one who ain't come undone? Everybody's lost their dang minds. When you check your feet, it's like clown TV, and you're waiting for the punchline. Oh, mama, hey, yeah.
Oh. Is today a good day to be unpopular there by Skillet there? Great lyrics of that one there. They're the two songs. You've got Gable Price and Friends, new band, something, you know, a little bit different, a little bit modern, and then Skillet with their massive rock sound with Unpopular. Which song do you want to choose? If you head over to our Facebook page or our Instagram, you can vote in the comments, and you can also find on Facebook, Rise and Shine on Facebook, you'll find links to the brand new video clips for both of those songs. We'll put the lyrics up there as well. I know some people really love to read the lyrics, and some links up there so if you want to know some more. But have a listen. We're going to be revisiting that this week and give you a chance to vote on something. Is it going to be Gable Price and Friends? That's from Ruth, or Skillet from Marky Van? Which one are you voting for on Spin It or Pin It?
Just the right mix of things to inspire and things to make you smile. Rise and Shine with Fel and DJ on Vision.
Fel and DJ.
We're talking all things The Chosen.
That's
the Chosen Con.
The Chosen Con. So it's a virtual for us. There's a gathering with the cast, the crew, the creators, and the global Chosen community. It is happening in person in Orlando.
Yes.
But if you can't get there yourself, we've got some virtual tickets.
I don't think we'll be able to make it.
No, we'll be a bit busy. And we actually can't get these because we can't enter. But if you are a huge Chosen fan and you're like, I'd like to virtually attend,
yeah,
it's only 11 days away. So it's over the 20th and the 21st of September.
Mm-hmm.
And you could virtually be with them all in Orlando for the Chosen Con.
So all we're asking you to do is give us your favorite quote from The Chosen. Any episode of The Chosen, there's four seasons to choose from. And we've got a call on the line now. We've got Greg here. Greg, are you a big fan of The Chosen?
I've only watched one half of one episode.
Oh. Well, that's about what I'm up to.
My sister-in-law watches them all the time.
Yeah.
And she recommends, you know, you must, it's a must do, watch all these Chosen TV or do digital appearances, you know.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
I've
yeah.
Watched half of one, so I'm sorry. But I'll just have a
few
of them. Someone's saying, you know, you'll live forever.
Well, do you remember any quote from that first half that you saw? Anything that anybody said?
Where is he hiding?
There you go. Done.
There we go. Done. Done. We'll give you that. I don't know if that's officially one of the official lines.
It sounds like it would be. Well done, Greg. You win.
It sounds like a great. This is going to be a great gift to give to. Did you say your sister-in-law is a massive fan?
Yes. Yes.
All right.
She's the one that directed me to watch these shows, and I don't watch TV, but I just have a computer, a laptop, so
yeah.
I'll be watching it on there. I do have a big screen, which can maybe USB or Bluetooth.
Okay.
Got to get the media happening, you know.
Okay, easy peasy. Well, I reckon you might have to invite the sister-in-law over, or you go over there and you go and watch the ChosenCon together, and you can be immersed in the Chosen universe straight away. Congratulations, Greg.
Oh, thank you kindly.
Well, that is how it's done. If you've watched half of an episode or all of the episodes, yeah, you're just as open to the prize.
Okay.
You just have to give us a call.
I know there's hardcore fans out there listening to Greg and going, you know, come on, I can do it. Listen, give us a call. No one's stopping you. 1-800-316-316. Get that favourite quote and you can get a great virtual pass to see the Chosen Con online. Don't forget, you're going to be able to see interviews with all your favourite actors and a live performance from Phil Wickham himself.
Rise and shine with Fel and DJ. Fel and DJ on Vision Christian Radio.
Bay Turner, brand new. You're on Rise and Shine with Fel and DJ, and we're giving away some tickets.
Yeah, we're giving away tickets to The Chosen Con. For all of you people out there who are fans of The Chosen television series, now up to season 4, they're filming season 5 as we speak. They're about to launch The Chosen Con, the second one they've done in Florida, but we've got some tickets to give away, and we're asking you to give us a call, 1-800-316-316, with your best line from The Chosen. I can see we've got Georgia here. Georgia, are you a fan of Chosen Con?
Well, actually, I'm a Chosen fan. I don't know what Chosen Con is.
Oh, well, there you go. I'm sure if you're a fan of the Chosen Con can only be a good thing.
Basically, a big conference where all the actors, the directors, the writers, you know, musicians and everything get together from The Chosen and just interact with the fans. Interviews, you know, talks, performances, all that type of stuff. So you get an online virtual ticket, so you get to watch everything and interact online.
That's awesome.
Yeah, we think it's awesome. So all you need to do to win, Georgia, is give us your favourite The Chosen quote. Have you got a favourite quote from the series?
Yes, I do. When Jesus says Mary, after she walks out of the bar and
yes,
he's standing there at a distance and he says her name.
Yeah,
that's brilliant. Just one word, that's it.
That's all it takes. I mean, that is fantastic, Georgia. And I just love that you've won it with a single
with one word.
Legendary.
I love it. And for fans, I mean, that is an impactful scene right there. That just crushes you.
I just bawled my
eyes. Yeah.
I love it.
She was seen and known, wasn't she, Georgia?
Far out.
Yeah. Yeah. I love it. Well, sound the line. We'll grab your details and we'll get you via email a virtual ticket to this wonderful event. But, Georgia, congratulations. You've won a pass to the Chosen Con.
Yay. Thank you very much.
Yay. I was so excited that Georgia gets to go along. Well, stay at home, actually. Go along. What better way to go to a conference, actually? And so if you'd like to be like Georgia, even just one word. I mean, yes, we haven't had a syllable yet. Maybe there's a favourite syllable from The Chosen. That could be. That's the only way I can get quicker.
I want some actual lines here. I want some actual lines. We've given away two of the passes. We've got two more to give away. 1-800-316-316. Fans of The Chosen, we're calling you. Get that favourite quote and give us a call.
Rise and show.
And we're giving away some tickets to the Chosen Con.
Yeah, the Chosen Con in, I think it's something in Florida, Orlando. And if you can't get there in person, like we can't get there in person, but you're a big fan of the Chosen, we can give you some tickets to watch it virtually online. We're asking you to give us a call and give us your favourite Chosen quote. On the line right now, we've got the lovely Belinda from Portland. Now, Belinda, you're telling us that you've seen just a part of The Chosen?
Did see it with a very dear friend of mine who used to say to me all the time, Belinda, have you watched The Chosen yet?
Yeah.
Have you watched The Chosen yet?
Yeah.
And I still haven't watched it, but the scene I do remember was when there are a whole group of people with Jesus and he was sitting down and they had like just like a campfire, you know, they were just doing their normal thing that everybody else does, but the range of people were young children and older people and stuff like that. And I do remember sitting with Cynthia watching it thinking, isn't that beautiful? I should watch this show. But I haven't.
But, okay, so I actually love that.
The question
you
is,
you sound like me.
Yeah, exactly. Do you have any, do you remember any of the lines, quotes, anything from what you saw?
I do not, because we used to just sit in each other's presence and just, Cynthia and I, and just do stuff, you know, like maybe talk to each other, maybe not. But we were talking and I remember looking at that scene thinking, that is so what we do now.
Okay.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
If we were able to give you a pass to the ChosenCon, do you reckon you'd be able to go over and watch it with your good friend Cynthia?
I would absolutely love to give it to her.
I think this is a great, we would love to give you this gift to be able to do and have a special moment with her, because it sounds like she's going to appreciate it a lot, and you might even, you know, you might be sparked into watching more of The Chosen. I think that's a great thing to do.
All right. Beautiful.
Oh, that is beautiful. And we love that Belinda's got involved. So now we've had a word.
Yes.
Another word, and now nothing, and we're giving away the tickets. So it's obviously very easy, but we only have one more pass.
We're very generous. We're very generous around here. This is great. Love it. If you're a big fan of The Chosen, come on, you've got to give us a big quote, give us a line, or maybe not, and you can do that
either
right
way.
Now. We've only got one more pass to give away.
Rise and shine.
Rise and shine.
Fel, we've got one more pass to give away, and I can see right now I've got on the line Malcolm. Malcolm, it says here, you're in Victor Harbour?
Yeah, that's right, yep.
How's Victor Harbour this morning?
Beautiful, actually. The sun's out, which is nice.
Nice, very nice. Now, Chosen, are you a fan? Have you, or are you like everybody else this morning, has seen half an episode, one episode, heard of it in passing?
I have watched a bit more than one or half.
There you go.
We're halfway through season four. So
Let's go. All right, well, here we go. We would love to send you to the Chosen Con virtually online. All you need to do is give us your favourite line so far from The Chosen.
Yeah, so it's not actually my favourite, but it's one of my family members, and it is when Jesus says to Simon Peter, when he has just invited Matthew to be his disciple, Peter said, "But he's different. Why do you ask him?" basically. And Jesus said, "Get used to different."
Ah, that's a great line.
I love it.
Used to different.
I think it's so great. They The Chosen have even put it on a few T-shirts and hats and things like that. I love that one.
Are you guys using that at home a bit? Is that what you say now? I would say that to the kids, I think.
I love it. That's great. Well, listen, Malcolm, congratulations. You've won a pass to the Chosen Con. We'll grab your details, we'll grab your email address and everything like that, and you can watch it virtually from the comfort of your own home and see all the actors, the directors. Phil Wickham is going to be doing a live performance as well, so it's going to be fantastic.
Awesome. Thanks.
Oh, well done. That is it. That is our four passes all given away. You can still play just for fun and tell us your favourite line.
Well, yeah.
We'll take that anytime.
Or you can head over to The Chosen on the website and click on ChosenCon and you can buy your own tickets.
Well, that is true.
And head over there and see all The ChosenCon for yourself. It's absolutely fantastic. Thank you to everybody. Congratulations. Big congratulations to Greg, Georgia, Belinda and Malcolm, who've all got a pass.
Getting you up and ready to face the day. This is Rise and Shine with Fel and DJ on Vision.
We're coming near to the end now of the show. We've almost got to the curtain call coming up next. But before we do, a little bit of a flashback actually to Friday. Remember, DJ, we were talking about those games you can play in the car.
Well, you just mentioned it when you're in the top of the hour there. Some of the games, the bingo game was one of them.
Yeah, that's right. So much fun. Well, we've had an awesome call here. I think I've got Jack on the line. Jack, how are you doing?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
Awesome.
We are all the better for hearing from Philip's legendary son, Jack. What can we do for you, buddy?
Hi. I'm just calling for the game.
Awesome. What game?
Car game.
What game do you guys play in the car?
We play one we call the ABC game.
I love that. Tell us all about it.
How does it work?
Okay, so you start the game, and when you're driving, you've got to look for the things and race your opponent. So, like, for A, you've got to find, like, Australia the word. and then move on to B until you get to Z.
Some of them would be hard.
So does it go? It's not I spy. It's you're talking about like somebody finding something that begins with the letter A, and then the next person repeats the A and then goes on to B. Is it like that?
No. Well, kind of. You're racing.
Yes.
To get to Z.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh. Okay. So it's excellent. Competition
There's a race,
against each
even
other.
Better. I love a competition, Jack. Are you quite good at it?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm pretty good.
Yeah.
Who are you playing against? Are you playing against mum and dad or are you playing against your siblings?
Well, I'm playing against dad right now.
Okay.
I'm going to work with him.
Ah.
So he knows this area, so he's winning.
Okay.
I mean, I tricked him a couple of times with Z, but he's winning. He's on Z, I'm on Q.
Oh, come on, Dad.
Well, yeah, I like this strategy of trick. Wait a minute, how are you tricking him with the letter Z? What are you doing?
Well, we just passed it, and we parked, and it's 50 metres behind us.
Okay.
There was a sign that said 11 at Simon with Z, and I was like, oh, Dad, look on that side. Look at all that steel.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh, yeah, that's cool. And I was like,
distracted. Mm-hmm. Clever.
You're using all the tactics
I
there.
Like that.
Yeah.
I'm on your team, 100% team Jack for the win.
I love it.
Well done.
Jack, we love this game. I love the fact that you and your dad are out there playing it together. Can you do us a favour and give your dad, Philip, a big high five for us?
Sure.
Well, when he stops driving, two hands on the wheel for now, Philip.
I like the fact that you're using vision for V as well, mate. That's a good one.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, buddy. Hey, thank you so much for your call.
You too. Bye.
Bye. Oh, there we go. I'm hoping Jack wins the game. I'm sure you will.
Well, he's got V covered for vision. Jack, you might even go D for DJ, F for Fell,
oh.
R for Rise. I don't know. Maybe you could stretch it a bit far.
We could come up with a few of the letters, couldn't we?
We'll love hearing from you, and we'd love to hear from you right now with a curtain call.
Hey, we call it our curtain call.
Imagine us at the stage here, about to take a bow. The curtain is about to close. What song do we finish off with? That's what we need to know. 1-800-316-316.
We've got Chris on the line.
So I want to request Overcomer.
Mm-hmm.
By Mandisa.
Yeah, that's right, in honour of her.
Awesome.
Because I did hear that she has passed on to glory, so...
Amen. Yeah, she has.
Yeah.
She has. Sadly, this year we lost a great voice, but we got this amazing song, and obviously it means a lot to you, Chris.
Yep.
Awesome. Well, let's play it out for you, Mandisa. Overcoming, going out to Chris this morning. Have a good one, mate.
Yep, thank you.
That's Mandisa going out to Chris for the curtain call. Great choice there with Overcomer.
A good one for your Monday morning. If you've got a curtain call that you want, let us know. 1-800-316-316. You can even send us a text. 0447-488-316. That's the number that you call. Oh, sorry, not call. Text. Don't call that number. Text us if you want to get a curtain call in as well. We've got a lot of stuff planned for tomorrow, including the ongoing Marriage Week.
That's right. This is Marriage Week, and we're supporting it here on Vision. What a wonderful thing to celebrate is marriage that was given by God. And so we'll have some more from Brett and Kate, and also Tony, obviously, from the newsroom, being a Tuesday.
Yay.
He's probably not marriage-related, but during the day, we are going to be making a call out. So you could get thinking now. We were trying to find those people that are listening along to our family who've been married the longest. So the longest married. We're going to have a prize up for grabs. So if you want to tap someone on the shoulder, if you want me to maybe say, hey, Mum, call Rise and Shine tomorrow.
Uh-huh.
We'd love to hear from you and hear a bit about your story.
I like it. I'm definitely not in contending. Me and Benita, 23 years. You and Murray about the same time?
We're 24, so we will always beat you. But I think that there'll be someone who's more than that. So if
someone's
you think
to,
you can.
Come on, Gab. We've got to beat Phil.
Right. I'm sure you can beat 24 years. But if you can, give us a call in the morning or send us a text and let us know and we can call you.
Yeah.
We would love to hear from some stories and advice from people who've been married the longest in
love
our
it.
Family.
Love it. It is Marriage Week all this week. Make sure you get across that on the Vision website. Well, whatever you're doing on this Monday as you kick off a brand new week, we're hoping and praying it's a great one. And we'll see you back here bright and early tomorrow morning. Bye-bye.
Thanks for taking time to listen to this audio on demand from Vision Christian Media. To find out more about us, go to vision.org.au.